and welcome to this video program of School of Education, Indira Gandhi National Open University. We are going to discuss and demonstrate the use of self-made audio video for classroom teaching learning. For this, I have with me Dr. Nisha Singh, Deputy Director, Inter-University Consortium IGNU. Welcome, Dr. Nisha.
Thank you.
And I have with me Mr. Ashish Kumar Abadhya, Assistant Director, Inter-University Consortium IGNU. Welcome, Mr. Ashish. I am Dr. Gaurav Singh from School of Education, Indira Gandhi National Open University. Friends, we all agree that in present ICT era, teaching learning process has changed a lot. Teachers have been asked to integrate ICT component in their classroom teaching. When teachers look towards integrating the ICT component, either they look for some websites like YouTube or they look towards some commercial players who are providing already developed audio video on different topics in name of e-learning. But when teachers used these audio video, they found that this is not as per their need and as per the objectives of the classroom teaching or the content. So our suggestion for them is to please develop their own audio video according to the objectives, according to the level of learner and according to the content. To help in that, we have organized this discussion today so that they can know that how to develop their own audio and video. To begin with, I would like to ask my colleague Dr. Nisha Singh, ma'am, please tell that how the audio video can help a teacher for teaching learning process.
Very good question, Dr. Gaurav. Teachers use a whole lot of learning, teaching learning resources to make their teaching learning effective. So these aids can be, as you said, are easily available on YouTube, but they are not as per their requirement. So they can use it for their requirement. They can make it gives them freedom because they are the best judge regarding the content, the methodology or the resources that are needed. Since they are making it, they can contextualize the content, they can relate it to daily experience, as well as it gives them freedom to develop them anywhere and use them anywhere and anytime.
Well said, Dr. Nisha, that they can use their own audio video as per their needs and demands. After this need and importance, one question triggers in my mind that what are the devices teachers can use to develop their own audio and video program?
You'll be amazed to know that the most easily available device today, a simple mobile we try to keep with us all time, anywhere, can be used for making audio and video recording. Most of the mobiles, whether it's a cheap mobile or a high-end mobile, they have audio and video recording facility. You can use it for recording an audio or a video and then you can develop into a teaching learning aid. A digital camera, we all have, that can be used. A computer, laptop with appropriate software can be used for developing either an audio or a video program.
You're right, Dr. Nisha, that they can develop the audio video programs as per their needs and demands with the help of mobile, laptops and their own computers. But what kind of program they can develop? What are different formats of different audio programs and video programs which they can develop for using in classroom?
Rightly asked, because there is a whole spectrum of programs which are available, but we have to keep in mind that while developing an audio program, we should see that we are developing creativity, imagination in children, and while developing in video program, concept attainment, concept development should be the main focus. A whole format available for audio is storytelling, poem, which is very interesting for children. Then basically it is used for developing language and communication skills among children. Then your interview, discussion, lecture, they all can be used in audio. Another one is reminiscences, memoirs. People can share their experiences and that will be very interesting for children. For video, you have documentaries also, you can record a natural event, you have interviews, discussions, live demonstrations, live events, then again lecture and you can make a report or you can make a documentary also.
Oh, these are a bunch of suitable formats, but teacher should select that which format is useful for them as per the nature of content, as per the size of the class and as per the need of the hour. When let us be specific a bit and let us move towards the development of audio program. Mr. Ashish, can you tell me what devices or software can be used for developing or recording an audio program?
Correct, Dr. Gaurav. As Dr. Nitha rightly said, that audio is very important component of teaching learning aid. The best available device to create any audio is mobile with your hand. You can record your audio in your mobile. Also, you can develop audio clippings through your laptop, through your computer by using Audacity software. I would like to tell you about one software that is known as Audacity, which is free, easy to use software. The software is used to record any audio. This software is also used to edit any audio which is already pre-recorded with you. You can edit, you can cut, you can copy, you can paste and do many more things with this Audacity software. Once you click on the Audacity software link, you will be able to see the home page of Audacity. As you see the highlighted boxes, there are two highlighted boxes. One is for Audacity and one is for Lame MP3 player. Audacity software is a software where you will record your audio, you will edit your audio. Lame MP3 is a plugin. It is a plugin for Audacity software and it is used to convert your recorded audio into MP3 file format. What you have to do? You have to first install the download the Audacity, install this, add a Lame plugin which is required for converting your files into MP3. As you see, this is the home page of Audacity software.
So, Dr. Ashish, it means that it is a free open source software. Teachers can download it on their own computer, on their own laptop. They can use it to develop their own audio programs and they can edit those audio programs, and with the help of Lame MP3, they can save it and convert it into a MP3 format. It is a very good information for them, and it will be better if you demonstrate it live, that how they can record, how they can edit, how they can save an audio program on Audacity. I think this is the home page where you want to demonstrate it.
Correct, Dr. Gaurav. In this exercise, we will actually see the two things: how to record the audio, how to save this audio into MP3 format, then how to import any pre-recorded audio into Audacity, then edit this. First, we will see the first exercise. You can see in the screen, this is the home page of Audacity. As you see these buttons, red button, green button, these buttons are similar in the tape recorder which is at your home. This is the red button for recording, stop. This is green button for play and pause. We can do the recording in the Audacity. Let's first see how to record in Audacity. To record any audio clipping in this, you have to first click on this record button. See, I have clicked on this record button. As you see the movements in the waves, this shows that recording is going on. Now, suppose we have done with our recording, you have to click on stop button. See, our recording is done. Now, let's play this recording. As you may be listening, that the sound voice is very low. This we can edit in the later phase through the edit option. Right now, let's see how to save this file is in as an MP3 format. First, go to file, click on export audio. Once you click on export audio, you will see the this screen, where you have to write the name of your file. Suppose I am writing test2, I will save this in my desktop, in this folder, I will click on save, then I will click on OK. See, this is your file is done. Now, you want to see the file. This is the test2 file which we have imported from Audacity as an MP3 format. Let's play this file. We'll click on play. this is the MP3 file which we have saved is open now and it is being played. Now we will close this file and now we will see how to edit any pre-recorded video audio with you. First, okay. We will close this clipping. To import any pre-recorded audio, we have to click on file, we have to click on import audio. I have one audio of school chale hum, I will click on this, then I will click on open. See, the file is being imported and file is available now with on your Audacity. Let us play this clipping. See, Dr. Gaurav, as you can see in this clipping, this is a sound of bell.
Okay.
Suppose we want this bell sound to be cut from here, what we have to do? We have to simply select this section, we have to go to edit, we have to go to cut. Once we clicked on cut, the bell sound clipping has been cut from here and now if you want to paste it here, you go here, click on edit, click on paste, your bell sound is now pasted over here. In the same way, suppose you want to copy this bell sound and paste somewhere, you select this section, go to edit, click on copy, then click where you want to paste it, then again go to edit and go to paste, you can paste this section. Now we have seen how to cut, copy and paste of any audio clipping. Now let us see how to add effects in the audio clippings. For this, suppose we select this section, let us play first this section so that we can hear the sounds. See, now we have this sound clipping. Let us see how to do edits on this clipping. First, we will select the clipping where we want to do edit. Select this clipping, go to effect, first go to amplify. The amplify feature is used when you have very low voice or very high voice. When you have very low voice, you can increase the amplification, or you have very low voice, high voice, you can decrease the amplification. Here, we will increase the amplification by 10 points. We'll click on allow clipping, we click on OK. See, you can see the changes in the waves. Now, we will hear the waves. I'll click on play. See the change. As we can hear the amplification in the voice, earlier the voice was bit less, now after amplification the voice has been amplified. And now see the different effect of this. We will click on effect, we will click on change pitch, we will increase the pitch by around 30 points, we will click on OK, the pitch has been changed. Now let us play this audio. See, we are able to recognize the difference in the pitch. We have increased the pitch has been changed. In the same way, we can do many more changes in the audio clippings. We can increase the speed, we can change the tempo, we can do fade in, fade out, we can repair the audio, we can remove the noise level, lot of things we can do in this Audacity software.
Dr. Ashish has very comprehensively explained the downloading of the Audacity, how to use it, how to record it for editing. Can you quickly recall the major steps of this recording of audio on Audacity?
Yes, Dr. Gaurav, I will just repeat the whole step what we have done. Suppose you want to work on Audacity software. first you have to download the software, you have to install the Audacity, then you have to install the LAME MP3 which is required for converting your file into MP3 format. Suppose you want to cut, copy, paste, you simply click on the select the portion of the clipping, go to edit, cut, copy and paste, you can do. Once you have done with your things, you can go to file, then go to export and export this file into MP3. In the same way, suppose you have already pre-recorded video, you go to Audacity, then click on file, click on import, select your Audacity, select your MP3 file, import this file, then select the clipping where you want to do any effect, then you click on effects, select the effect which you want to add, then add it into your clipping.
Very nicely explained by Ashish ji, and he has repeated also the major steps of developing, recording and editing in audio. Let us move from audio towards the video, another section of our discussion. We have with us Dr. Nisha Singh. Ma'am, what are the basic tools or softwares are required to develop a video program for classroom purposes?
As we have already discussed that we can use a mobile for video recording, the mobile clipping can be used. Another, we can use computer or laptop, the screencast softwares of the laptop can be used. So, we can use Cam Studio, we can use S Recorder, and for demonstration purpose we will be using S Recorder here. Let us give a live demonstration of how to use S Recorder. You can go to the website, download it, install as you install Audacity, and a screen will open. You will see that there is a change in the screen of the color of the screen, okay. And then you can select an area which you want to record the process. Okay. After selection area, you will see that a button is on the below the screen. And you record the button, and then the whole process will get recorded. You go to all programs. Suppose we have to teach about paint, all programs, accessories, paint will open. And now you can tell the child how to use paint application in the computer. See, we can draw a rectangle, a square, color it, any color we can use, any drawing we can do, and then we can simply save this.
Okay.
Save this video clipping on any place, suppose on your desktop, give it a name so that it is easily identifiable. Then this clipping can be used later by children at home, okay, to recapitulate, revise as to how the teacher taught in the class, as well as we can give it to parents so that they know as to how the children learned, and we can also develop the capacity of parents to be at par with the ICT what their children are learning in the classroom. Okay. So it's very good software, and again I'll just repeat the steps. You have to open the S Recorder. The screen will open, select the area, there will be a button downstairs which will show you as to you have to record that particular area, then record it, save the file, and then you can use it and as the way you want.
Ma'am, when we record a video on our mobile or on our digital camera, sometimes it fails to play when we play it or upload it on web page or in PPT. So, what are the formats supported by various platforms? Can you explain in brief that what are various formats which are being supported by various platforms for video program?
A very apt question, Dr. Gaurav, because we often face this problem. Suppose we have a MP4 file is with us and we want to use it in PPT, it won't support. So we want a WMV file. Similarly, for website, we need a FLV file, AVI file, and then social media also we need these files. So if we have a MP4 file, how do we convert into a WMV file? That can be easily done. How? Okay. Then we can use a software called Any Video Converter software, which is free and easily available. You have to go to the site of Any Video Converter, download it, it converts one file format to another very easily. Okay, let's have a live demonstration.
Yeah, we will have a live demonstration, and you rightly said that every platform requires a different kind of format of a video program. And I think that this live demonstration which you are going to show will definitely help them so that they know that how to convert a pre-recorded video, whether it is from a mobile or it is from a digital camera, to a desired format so that they can use into their PowerPoint presentation, they can use in their web page of the school, or they can upload it on social media platforms also. So let us move towards the demonstration.
Okay, once you click on AVC, the home page will come. As you can see on the top bar, there is an ad video. You have a video which you have recorded from a mobile, ad video. It's on the desktop. We'll insert it or import it, as we say, ad video. The video is added. And if you want to convert into a platform, into a desired format, we'll select that particular format. Suppose we are doing WMV format. We'll change into WMV format. You can see on the right hand side of the top bar, WMV format. Now convert now. That is the action. Convert now. And see, the file is being converted.
Right. And I think we can convert in any desired format.
Yes, true. We can convert in any desired format, whichever you need. So you have to decide it beforehand which format you need. That is very crucial. So as it is converting, it will take some time, but the output will be there and it will be into your desired format. So again, it's simple. Add video, select the format. It will across the operating systems, many formats are available. Select the format you want.
Okay.
Convert now. And once you click on convert now, the video will get converted into the desired format. The desired format we are doing right now is WMV.
So the file WMV will be is fit for PowerPoint presentation.
As a classroom teacher, we need PowerPoint presentation.
Definitely,
we
definitely
often use it. So that is the most relevant, and we can see it's almost done.
Done.
And it will come on the, in an output folder, which is on the left hand side. You can see if output folder, click on that and you have it. It will run for you.
Okay. So this is the folder.
This is a clipping which was recording in the natural setting.
Okay.
And I have think lot of fishes, so children will get very excited. Oh, so many fishes.
They can record anywhere all these things. So I think at the last, I would like to ask one more questions, that what are the general precautions or general considerations should be kept in mind when a teacher is going to develop an audio or video program?
Very important question. You have to be very clear as to your objective of your the audio video aid you want to make. Why do you want to make? Where do you want to launch it? It is a website or a PPT. So that has to be clear, and accordingly you develop your audio and video, and you can change it into a desired format using AVC, which you have already learned how to use it. One thing you have to be very careful about, the size of the file. Try to make it small. It should not be a heavy file, because some websites restrict the heavy load of uploading of heavy files, or even it will take more time, so children will get impatient. So please try to have a less weight file.
So friends, Dr. Nisha and Mr. Ashish have demonstrated the simple steps of using an audio or video program for classroom purpose. I hope when you will practice it at your home, you will get acclimatized with it and you will be an expert in it very soon. And I'm very much thankful to Dr. Nisha Singh and Mr. Ashish that they have demonstrated it beautifully for our learners. And I hope that you will use it, you will develop your own audio video, and you make your teaching learning more effective. All the best to all of you, and thank you very much.